Swayam Prabha, Digital India, Educated India.
Welcome to this session on sustainability standards. So in the previous few session, we are trying to understand how the Indian companies they are doing in terms of their corporate social responsibility, what is the difference between corporate social responsibility and corporate social sustainability, little bit about the philosophical aspect of the social sustainability, and then also we discuss about the UN Sustainable Development Goals and how typically this goal or the sustainable development goals, these are aligned to the corporate strategy or how this plan of action is being integrated into the corporate strategy. So in this session, we will discuss the sustainability standard. We have picked few sustainability standard what is relevant from ISO, and also there are few other sustainability standard which are relevant in this case. So to start with, what is sustainability standards? So, sustainability standards or certification, this is the voluntary guideline that is used by producer, manufacturer, traders, retailer and the service provider. And why do they use this? To demonstrate their commitment to good environmental, social, ethical and food safety practices. So, if you see that the standard, the bottom line for this standard is again triple bottom line, and apart from this also some additional importance like food safety practices and many more other agenda. So, the trend of this sustainability standard started in late 1980s and 90s, and one of few initial standards or certifications are eco level and standards for organic foods and few other standards. So, sometime in late 1980s and 90s, the standards, the trend of using a standard, the trend of taking a certification for the standard is started in that time period. So, now why standards are developed? So, standards are normally developed by the stakeholders and expert in the particular sector. And what they do, what they give in term or what they provide in term of the standards, they give a set of practices or criteria, or let us say the best practices or the criteria which will help to for the business performance by considering their commitment towards environmental, social, ethical, financial and the other agenda of the sustainability. And it includes the sustainable standards, it includes a set of criteria and set of practices or set of criteria. So, the typical example can be over here is that, let us say that sustainably grown crop, like if you remember in case of Levi's jeans, we are discussing about that cotton cultivation, how it can be sustainable grown. Similarly, ethically harvested resources, whatever the resources we are using in the production process or the organization they are using in the production process, how it is ethically harvested. Fair wage for all, the organization should ensure the fair wage for all, whatever their wages, that how this can, this has to be paid to all the employee. Similarly, the protection of marine biodiversity, these are few of the examples what where you will find that the sustainability standard comes with a set of practices or set of criteria. Typically, this sustainable standard, it accompanied by a verification process, and this referred as a certification. So, whatever the verification process accompanied by the sustainability standard, this is known as the certification. We will see at a later point of time that even if certification is not mandatory, still just by following the standards, the practices given in the standards, the framework given in the standard, if that is being used by the organization, that helps in achieving the efficiency or helps in achieving the business performance. And why this verification process is part of it, or why the certification is part of it? Because by doing this, by taking this certification or by taking this verification process, this has to be evaluated the compliance and the traceability. So typically, if the organization is using a standard, how do we verify that whether they are using the standards or not? That is, if there is a certification, that is ensure, because there would be a compliance to this and also there would be a traceability to this, that in the traceability is not in one point of time, it is across the supply chain, that whether they have used the standard properly or they have just taken it for the namesake. To start with, let us see the standard what is mostly used by the organization, that is the environmental management standard, that is ISO 14001. So, what is this standard, what is this ISO 14001? It sets out a criteria for an environmental management system, and this can be certified too. So, this give a criteria for the environmental management system of the organization, and also it you can get a, or the organization can get a certification for this ISO 14001. They maps out a framework for the company or the organization to follow or can follow to set up an effective environmental management system. They helps the organization to improve the environmental performance through most efficient use of resources, reduction of waste, gaining competitive advantage, and finally, since they use the standard, also it helps them to gain the trust of the stakeholders that they are following a fair business process, or their business performance is, the environmental impact associated with the business performance is not high. So, this ISO 14001 is developed by the ISO technical committee and also the various subcommittee, and it provides the requirement with the guidance for use that relates to environmental system. So, if you look at the ISO standard, so one way they give the framework and also they give a guidance that how to use that standard. So, typically they hold the training, they hold the capacity building program, that when they are adopting a standard, how do they use the framework or how do they operationalize the framework. So, there are other standards in ISO 14001 family which focuses on audits, communication, leveling, life cycle analysis, as well as the environmental challenges and climate change. So, if you remember in the LCA, when we are discussing about the life cycle analysis, how each of the activity or each of the component is related to one of the standard of this ISO 14001 family. So, the one and here one of the information is that up to now, this total certification in ISO 14000 is 300,000, and this is spread across 171 countries around the world. Now, this ISO 14001 and also ISO 9001, which is associated with the quality management practices, these are all generic. It is applicable to organization of all types, all size, whether it is private, not for profit, public, governmental, regulatory. So, it is applicable to all organization types. This is of all types and all size. So, this is known as generic standard. And the requirement what is needed for this ISO 14001 is that all environmental issues relevant to an organizational operation that can come under the framework, like your air pollution, water and sewage issue, waste management, then mitigation, adaptation, resource use and efficiency. So, this can be very specific to each of the domain where there is a environmental impact associated with the product life cycle. So, when it comes to certification, it is not requirement, it is not a requirement, even if the company or the organization, they are not taking a certification, they can still use the ISO 14001 certification, ISO 14001 framework. But there is a provision of the third party certification in ISO 14001, and this certification is mainly is a way to signal the buyers, customers, suppliers and other stakeholders that the organization has implemented the standard properly. So, if you remember this point also we are discussing in the previous slide, that the certification ensures that compliance and also the traceability. So here, even if certification is not a requirement to use the ISO 14001, typically the organization, those who are successfully using the standard for some period of time, they prefer to go for a certification, because this work is a signal tools for the other stakeholder that the standard is being used properly. Now let's see what is environmental management system. So environmental management system helps organization to identify, manage, monitor, control and their environmental issue in a holistic manner. So it is a continual cycle of planning, implementing, reviewing, improving the process and action that an organization undertake to meet the business and the environmental goal. So EMS is that system which takes care of all activities related to meeting the business and the environmental goals. So it may be the planning, it may be the action, it may be the implementation, it may be the reviewing, everything what comes under the system to meet the business and the environmental goals, that is typically known as the environmental management system. So most of the EMSs are built on this PDCA model. What is this PDCA model? P is for plan. Here the identify the environmental aspect and establish goal, then do, that is train and establish the operational control, implement the plan, check, review and monitor, and act, that is take corrective action to make changes to the EMS as necessary. So this EMS, they are built on a model that is known as a PDCA model. Now what is the requirement for a ISO 14001, typically why the standard is being accepted? So first one is to establish an environmental policy, then also determining the environmental aspect, their impact on product, activity and services, planning for environmental objective, measurable targets, implementation and operation program to meet the objective and targets, checking and corrective actions and management review. So if you look at this broadly whatever we are discussing in the previous slide, that is PDCA, this activity can come under your plan, the activity can come under your do, the activity can come under act, on the this can be part of the entire PDCA, that is check and act. Now what are the benefits of ISO 14001? So these are what benefit ISO 14001, which is taken from this ISO.org. But here, before getting into the benefit of ISO 14001, let me tell you there is a series of research literature which talks about or which establish the fact that this voluntary measure, because ISO 14001 is voluntary in many countries, and typically this comes under the voluntary compliance or voluntary standard. So the research literature, they establish the fact that, so one is that what is the effectiveness of the formal regulation, formal compliance. The other is that, so when, what is the effectiveness of this informal compliance. So if you see across the globe in the different cross country perspective and also in case of Indian perspective, this ISO 14001 leads to corporate environmental performance to better one. So there is an increase in the corporate environmental performance if there is an adoption of ISO 14001 by the organization or by the company. So before getting into this, each of these benefits, as a whole there is an empirical literature or there is an empirical investigation through the research literature that there is a benefit of ISO 14001 which leads to increase or improve the corporate environmental performance, and that gives a clear signal that those industry or those company, those who have not used this ISO 14001, possibly they can use it and get the benefit associated with this ISO 14001. Now this, now coming to the point what have been listed over here, that it demonstrates the compliance with the current, future statutory and regulatory requirement. Then it increases the leadership involvement and the engagement of employee. It improves the company reputation, confidence of the stakeholder. Then also it achieves the static business aim by incorporating environmental issue into business management. Then it gives the competitive and the financial advantage through improved efficiency and reduced cost. and finally it encourages the better environmental performance of supplier by integrating them into the organization business system. Now let's get into the other ISO standard, ISO 26000. So this we discuss when we are discussing the social sustainability, because this is related to the standard associated with the social sustainability. So what is ISO 26000? It is international standard. It gives the guidance and the recommendation about how any organization can improve its social responsibility. So here this standard is specifically helps out the organization or gives the guidance to the organization that how they can improve the social responsibility and contribute to the sustainable environmental, social and economic development. This is not certifiable. There is no certificate associated with ISO 26000, at least not developed till now, and as it does not contain any requirements. And typically this is appeals to those who seeks to improve their operating process and impact through their socially responsible behavior. So it is more about the guidance, it is more about the recommendation, it is more about the framework which helps the organization to achieve the or improve their social responsibility. So again we will see that how this ISO 26000 is also linked to our sustainable development goals, the standard which is linked to the different sustainable development goals. Then let's see how this standards and how this is linked to the sustainable development goals. Now what is sustainable development goals? This is typically given by UN, which the goals what we need to achieve by 2030. And in order to achieve this goal, there is a plan of action for each SDG. So there are 17 SDGs and there is plan of action for each of these SDGs. And this calls that when there is a plan of action for achieving each of these SDG, this requires the contribution for all elements in the society, including government, business, industry and individuals. So there are almost 22,000 international standard and related document that represent globally recognized guidelines and framework based on the internal collaboration. And here you will find for each of the goal of the sustainable development, for each goal in the sustainable development goals, the ISO, they have identified the standard that makes significant contribution to that development goals. And for each goal, it is not only one standard, you will find that there are numerous ISO standard that corresponding to each of this SDG. It means to achieve the, to help out in achieving the goal for each of these SDGs, there are many standards which are aligned or that they are giving the guidance or they are giving the framework. So here it is being summarized nicely that how each of the standard, how each of these SDGs, how this is aligned or how this is taking the help or the associate standard for each of this SDG. So if you look at your first goal, that is no poverty, there are 340 standards which will help in achieving these SDGs. Similarly, if you go to your goal 9, there are 12,424 standards associated with this goal. And similarly, if you look at the numbers at the top of each of this goal, this gives the idea that how many standards are there which can help in achieving this goal or which can give the guidance or the framework for achieving this goal. Let's see few of the standards, a few of the sustainable development goals and how it is aligned or how, what are the associated standard or what are the relevant standards for them, few of them. Let's see that goal 2 is our zero hunger. So SDG goal 2 is zero hunger. Now there are 1600 standards for the food production sector. And what the role of the standards? The role of the standard in this food production sector is designed to create confidence in food products, improves the agricultural methods, promotes sustainable and ethical purchasing. Other areas including nutritional safety, nutritional and safety testing, quality packaging and traceability. Similarly, what may be the other standard which will, specific standard which may be useful for goal 2? that is ISO 22000 family of standards on food safety management helps, that is, to organization to identify control the food safety hazards, ISO 26000 for social responsibility, ISO 20400 encourage socially. Both these ISO 26000 and ISO 20400, they encourage the socially responsible behavior and ethical working condition for agricultural worker and promote the ethical purchasing policy throughout the entire food supply chain, food production chain. Then ISO 4001 is a series of standard on sustainable and traceable coca beans, and also specify the requirement of management system in the bean farming. So, if you look at for the goal 2, the relevant standard or few of the relevant standard over here is that this, if the companies of the whoever the stakeholders, if they are following these standards, that will help them to achieve the goal 2, that is zero hunger. Now, let us go to goal 12, which is quite relevant for the sustainability agenda or for the sustainable development, that is responsible consumption and production. Now, what is sustainable consumption and production? It promote the use of few of the intervention or few of the highlights that promote the use of renewable resources, renewable source of energy, encourage responsible purchasing decision, and some of the way this ISO standard contributes in working towards this goal. Now, what are few of the standards? Like in the previous slide also we are discussing ISO 20400, which provides the guidance to the organization for incorporating sustainability into their procurement function. Similarly, ISO 14020, that is environmental labeling, they give the guiding principle for the development and use of environmental label and the self declaration, preparing for the third party certification. So, if you remember when we are discussing eco labeling, there are three types of eco labels. So, here they also, this ISO 14020, they helps in preparing the organization for the third party certification and also help to validate the environmental claims and encourage consumer to make the better choice. Then few more relevant for goal 12 is ISO 15392, that is sustainability in construction, that is building construction. They identify and establishes the general principle of sustainability in building and other construction work throughout their whole life cycle from inception to end of life. And ISO 20245, that is sustainable lifestyle choices, deals with the cross border trade of second hand goods, establish the minimum screening criteria for good traded between the country, and helps to drive this alternative consumption pattern by reducing waste and the environmental impact. Similarly, we have goal 13, that is climate action. And what is this goal 13? Goal 13, the relevant standard here is that ISO 14000 family of standard for EMS, and they details the practical tools for the organization as we discuss, and to manage the impact their activity on the environment. And this we have already discussed that what it deals with ISO 14001, and each of them contribute to the climate change responses or to mitigate the effect associated with the climate change. Now, few more series of this 14000 family, that is ISO 14064 for quantification, monitoring, validation and verification of greenhouse gas emission, 67 for quantifying and reporting the carbon footprint of the product, 80 give a framework to develop the consistent and comparable improved methodology in the fight against climate change, and ISO guide 84, which is currently being developed, is in the still in the development phase. It gives the guideline for addressing the climate change in standards and aimed at those involved in the standard development. Now, apart from this, also there are few more sustainability standards which is not part of ISO, and these are all voluntary in nature. So, one is fair trade. It is developed in late 1980 by Dutch development agency. So, you will find for many of the product, there is a logo associated with the fair trade. So next time when you buy specific product, just see that also the company in their sustainability report, in their website, you will find that they give a tag for this fair trade, and also there is a leveling for the fair trade. So next time you will find, if you are buying a product, just check that whether there is a fair trade. You may not get for all the product, but there are some of the product you find that fair trade. So this developed in late 1980s by a Dutch development agency with the collaboration from the Mexican farmers, and the focus of this standard is to access and improving position of the small producer, that is environmental objective. And apart from access and improving the position of the small producer, taking them to the market, getting a good price for their product, also apart from this, there is an additional focus, that is the environmental objective. So this fair trade label, what it talks about or what it gives, if there is a fair trade label, this is a guarantee of a minimum price what the producer they will get, and also it is a social premium that goes to the cooperative and not to the producer directly. Similarly, the other sustainability standard what you must have heard of is Rainforest Alliance, and this Rainforest Alliance, this standard created from a social movement in 1980s. And what they are committed to? They are committed to conserving the rainforest and their biodiversity. Now, what are the key elements? The key elements of Rainforest Alliance is to development of a sustainable farm management system to assist the wildlife conservation, and to improve the workers' welfare by establishing and securing the sustainable livelihood. So, Rainforest Alliance is mostly about conserving the rainforest, developing a sustainable farm management system for the wildlife conservation, and also increasing the workers' welfare by establishing and securing the sustainable livelihood. So there are few more sustainability standard, voluntary standard, which we will discuss in the next session. So to summarize the entire session, what we have discussed over here is that to understand what are the different ISO standard which is applicable for sustainability and environment, how the sustainable development goal, for how for each of the sustainable goal there are different standards, the related standard or the relevant standard associated, which will help for the taking the plan of action to achieve the sustainable development goal, and few more voluntary standard. So we'll continue our discussion about the voluntary standard, mostly the voluntary sustainability standard, in the next session, and also we'll see that is there a business case for adopting the sustainability standard. Thank you.